Welcome to today's session. In this session, we'll continue with the module 3, about oscillator and clock. In this class, we'll define what you mean by 8051 oscillator and its clock frequency. As we know, 8051 at pin number 18 and 19 are connected with a quartz crystal, mentioned as XTAL1 and XTAL2. They are continuously producing clock frequencies as shown here, P1 and P2, XTAL1 with a P1, XTAL2 with a P2. Like this, the continuous clocks are produced by 8051. As it is stated here, two clock pulses are stated as one state. I'll repeat here, two clocks are stated as one state. Like this, there are how many states are there? There are the six states. Means the six states is equal to one machine cycle. Means one machine cycle is equal to six states. Each state consists of two clocks. I hope you know. And below this one is address latch enabled. As we told, whenever the address latch is enabled high, it will be passing with address. Whenever it is a low, it is passing with the data. I hope you know, got to know that there are the total how many states? Six states in a one machine cycle. And these clock frequencies are produced by 8051 with a frequency range from 1 to 16 megahertz. Means if I say this is my one clock frequency, it can have a frequency from between 1 to 16 megahertz. That is what previously I told. What do you mean by machine cycle? Machine cycle is nothing but the smallest time interval of time to accomplish any simple instructions. This is a time interval to execute a instruction. I'll come back to this one. And each machine cycle is made up of six states. State 1, state 2, state 3, state 4, 5, and 6. And each state consists of two oscillator period. And one machine cycle is equal to 12 oscillator period. As we can see here, whatever is given in diagram, the same thing I have told in the slide. Then how to calculate machine cycle? We take 1/12th of the crystal frequency. For any instruction, it will consume some machine cycle. If I want to calculate the time period to execute the particular instruction, by using equation T instruction is equal to C into 12D. I hope you know that why I took a 12 means one machine cycle is equal to 12 clocks. Divided by crystal frequency. The crystal frequency will be vary between 1 to 16 megahertz. And C is number of cycles. This is like in the bottom line, I have told with a frequency, 8051 has a crystal frequency of 11.0592 megahertz. I hope in sometime when we are executing in the laboratory, we are setting with this frequency. It is not exactly 12 megahertz, it is 11.0592 megahertz. That is what the crystal frequency of a 8051. For currently in this semester, we are using with this clock frequency. This is the appendix chart has been given by the manufacturer. It is given by the manufacturer. So each instruction okay, how much machine cycle it will consume. Okay, let me take the very first one, arithmetic operation. I don't want to go with all the instruction. Okay, it is available in appendix. Okay, otherwise you try to observe it. Okay, how to remember. So during your examination point of view, okay, during the calculation point of view, you require this machine cycle. Okay, let me take the first instruction here. Add A comma, the very first one, add A comma Rn, means it is adding content of accumulator with content of register Rn, any register between R0 to R7. It will consume one machine cycle. Okay, the particularly, I hope you can know this, just observe it. Okay, sometime in the examination, if you are not given the how much machine cycle will be there, all the add will be taking one machine cycle. Okay, similarly, the sub instructions are consuming one machine cycle. Okay, just for clarification, to know, okay, to understand or remember, you can get to know that it is consuming by default one machine cycle. You need not worry about the byte. Byte is not required for our calculation. Okay, to here, the next instruction is that INC will be consuming one machine cycle. Similarly, DEC is also consuming with one machine cycle. Okay, except, okay, INC DPTR. Okay, I hope you know that DPTR has a 16-bit register. So in fact, it is only, okay, it is only the instruction it will take, not only I say, this is the instruction it will take, consume two machine cycles. Okay, and other instruction, MUL will consume four machine cycles, DIV will consume four machine cycles. Okay, this is a brief, okay, which will be taken up from the appendix. Okay, it will be available, or you try to remember this. Okay, and all the logical operations, okay, except, okay, ANL with a direct comma data, means the data content of memory location is ANDed with immediate data, that will be consuming two machine cycles. Okay, and here, okay, few more will be given here. Data transfer here, I given here, move, this is in fact, move will be like very important for us, for our calculation, move, okay, except, copy from content of memory location to Rn, okay, I hope you can see here, Rn, okay, it will be taking two machine cycle, okay. This is quite, okay, the third column is quite important for us to use calculating the frequency. Okay, the continuation of the previous one, okay, there's some more instructions are available in 8051. Okay, how much machine cycle they are consuming, it is given here. Okay, the very important here, where we require most time, okay, DJNZ will be consuming two machine cycle. DJNZ, both, okay, that is from register RN comma REL, and DJNZ direct comma REL are consuming two machine cycle, and comparison instruction are also consuming two machine cycle, and our return RET is consuming two machine cycle. Okay, in fact, if I say two machine cycle, okay, one machine, how many cycles are there in one machine cycle? One machine cycle is equal to 12 clocks. So in fact, if I say two machine cycles, mean it will take CV comma 2 into 12 divided by whatever the clock frequency. Okay, because what we have given here, look at here. See, if I say two machine cycle, immediately you substitute with the C will be 2. 12, you can't change it. It's a 12. Okay, 2 into 12. Divided by whatever the crystal frequency of the processor. Okay. Now let me take with the one simple example to show how we do the calculation. Okay. The following shows a crystal frequency for three different 8051 based systems, and find the period of the machine cycle in each case. Okay. Let us take the first clock frequency will be 11.0592 megahertz, second one 16 megahertz, okay, and third one 20 megahertz, okay, and we assume, okay, here in this example there is no any kind of like a machine cycle for a particular instruction is given, so we will assume one machine cycle, okay. As from the equation, previous equation, we know that TINST is equal to C into 12D, okay, divided by crystal frequency. Now, at the very first one, A, what is the crystal frequency? 11.0592 megahertz, okay, that is 1 into 12, okay, is divided by 11.0592 megahertz, it will be coming with 1.085 microsecond. Means if there is an instruction, okay, with a given corresponding frequency 11.0592, it will be consuming 1.085 microsecond of time. Okay, similarly for the B, okay, one, okay, because machine cycle is one from the previous equation, 1 into 12 divided by 16 megahertz will get with the 0.75 microsecond of time for executing the particular instruction. Okay, similarly for the C, T instruction, that is 1 into 12 divided by 20 megahertz, it will be coming with 0.60 microsecond of a time for a one machine cycle of instruction. Let us take with like a second example, okay, for a 8051 system of a clock frequency 11.0592 megahertz, find how long it will take to execute the given instructions. Okay, the very first instruction, as we know, okay, you need not worry about the operation of this one. Okay, move R3 comma 55 means immediate data 55 is copied into R3. Second one, decrement R3. Content of register R3 will be decremented by 1. DJNZ R2 comma target means content of R2 will be decremented by 1. If it is not 0, it will be shifted or it will be jumped to the location target. LJMP long jump. SJMP short jump. NOP no operation. MUL AB, it is a multiply content of A with the content of B. Okay, as it is given, okay, these are the data will be taken from the appendix, okay, that is the very first instruction. The very first instruction, move R3 comma 55, will be consuming one machine cycle. Okay, now we know that, okay, there's an equation, again the same instruction, TNST is equal to 1 into 12 divided by 11.0592, okay, that is the below here, I took one example for you, okay, that is 1 into 12 divided by 11.0592 megahertz, it will be coming with 1.085 microsecond. Means my instruction, okay, move R3 comma 55 will be consuming 1.085 microsecond of time. Okay, similarly second one, similarly in the second, okay, that is a decrement R3 is also consuming one machine cycle. Means what is my TNST? Okay, that is a TNINST is equal to C into 12 divided by frequency. Okay, in second one, it will be consuming 1.085 of a microsecond. Okay. Similarly, C, okay, as I told, DJNZ R2 comma target, it will be taking two machine cycles. Means in this here, in C, at the numerator, C will be replaced by 2. Okay, that is clock frequency will be, as we know, 12, 2 into 12 divided by 11.0592, it will be coming with 2.17 microsecond. Okay. Similarly, for LJMP, there is a long jump, will be consuming 2 machine cycle, 2 into 1 into specified time period will be 2.17 microsecond. Similarly, for SJMP, it will be consuming 2 machine cycle, NOP, no operation, will be consuming 1 machine cycle, MUL, okay, will be consuming 4 machine cycle. Means MUL will be consuming total 4.34 microsecond of time interval for executing the particular instruction. Okay, I hope you understood how to do the calculation for each particular instruction execution time. Okay, this in fact is very important for us to calculate a time delay, okay, for the coming session. Okay, in fact, okay, I repeat here, okay, the equation will be, okay, the very clear for you. Okay, I'll repeat. One machine cycle is equal to, one machine cycles are is equal to how many states? There are 6 states. Okay, each state is consist of 2 clocks. Okay, since one machine cycle is equal to 12 clocks. Okay. I hope you understood, and in coming class we'll calculate a delay for the corresponding program. Thank you.